Praise the Lord. Good morning, everyone. God bless you. This is Pastor Carlos Rivera. Trying this one more time. I guess we're having a little bit of difficulty getting online this morning. There we go. All right. Praise God. Good morning, Louis Alvarez. First one on board. Yes, yes. I had a little challenge getting on this morning, Mr. Dennis Lopez, my prayer warrior brother. God bless you. Stanley Ridley. Wow. Good to see you, Stanley. God bless you, my brother. Glad you're on board. Yvette Sanders, Sharon Williams, Peggy Morningstar. Wow. Cindy Martinez, so glad you joined me this morning. Kim Cooper, Kathy Martin. It was good meeting you in person this Sunday, Kathy. God bless you. Lynn Bell, always a pleasure. Praise God. Mickey. Mickey's on here. Philip Sanders, God bless you as well. Lisa Jenkins. Oh, we're all coming on this morning. Nainine, hallelujah. Mateo, I'll see you, Matei. We'll see you shortly. Rosie, hallelujah. Peggy Stevens, Cindy Martinez, God bless you. So good to have you on board. Miss Elizabeth Albano, Peggy Stevens, yes. Good morning, Lisa, yes. Gilbert Estavillo, Gilbert, wow, praise God. Audrey Ross, Peggy Stevens, man, we're all on board. That's right. God bless you, Gilbert. So glad you joined us this morning. Along with Philip Sanders, Carmelo Vasquez. Yes, I am on. We are on. Hello, hello, hello. Come on, family. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Amen. Amen. Give me a little something to drink here real quick. Good morning. Oh, that tastes good. A little water with lime this morning. Hilda Bryant, cousin, God bless you. Yvonne Harrison, Michael Cook, Michelle Williams. Oh, we're all coming on board. Zaida Preston, bendiciones. Kay and Dre May, good morning, good morning, good morning. Praise God. It was kind of weird this morning. I tried to hit the button to get started, and I just kind of sat there, and it just kind of locked in, so I had to shut it all back down again and bring it all back up again, and now we're on board. So praise God, Miss Gloria Hicks. Good to have you on board as well. Amen, amen. Sharon Johnson. Yes, praise God. Well, you know what? Let's go ahead and get started this morning. Lavette Thompson, good to have you. Teofilio Ortiz, bendiciones, mi hermano. And well, you know, we're all on. We're all on, and more people are coming on as we go along. I want to welcome those that are on the conference call as well this morning. So let's go ahead and get started. Praise God. Listen, I've entitled our time together this morning. The title is Keep God First. Write that down in the chat right now. Come on, put it in the chat. Keep God First. Amen. Listen, look what Matthew chapter 6, verse 33 has to say. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Wow, what a powerful promise. You know, if you read the scripture before that, the Lord is talking about the needs that you have, you know, for clothing, for food, just all these things. And God's word is saying, listen, when you keep God first, when you keep him as a priority in your life, then all these other things will come. See, when you focus in on God, you'll realize that all that he provides for us is attainable to us. Amen. Listen, write this in the chat. If you're taking notes, let's go, team. Listen, pursue the blesser, not the blessing. Oh, come on, somebody. Write that in the chat right now. Pursue the blesser, not the blessing. See, so often we find ourselves wanting things that we feel will better our lives. And there's nothing wrong with that. But the problem is that we decide to find pleasure in material things. See, finding happiness in the things we chase after, they satisfy for a moment, but keep us wanting more. That's right. When you're chasing after the things of this world to fulfill you, you'll find out that they fall short every single time. You see, there's a void in our hearts. There's a space in our hearts that only God can fill. And when we try to fill it with other things, we find out that we're never satisfied. It's an insatiable thirst for things that continue to come into our lives. And they may satisfy for a moment, but they're not, they don't satisfy you at the deepest part of your life. And they sure don't satisfy you for a very long time. You have to keep going back to that well and drinking that same water when God is saying, listen, when you drink from the water that I give you, you'll never thirst again. You see, when we chase after God, what we desire chases after us. Oh my goodness. This is so good, y'all. When we chase after God, what we desire chases after us. And that is so powerful and so true. Keep life in the right order. Keep everything in the right perspective. Make sure your priorities are lined up and putting God first, amen, in your life. And you'll see that everything else will start falling into place, amen. And you know, so often we have all these needs that are kind of scattered around in our minds. But I believe this, and this is so, so very important. You need to identify your needs. That's right. Identify your needs. Put that in the chat right now if you're with me. Identify your needs. Look what Philippians chapter 4, verse 19 has to say. But my God, come on somebody, but my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. What a powerful promise God has given every single one of us. Identify your needs. Remember, write this in the chat. We're taking lots of notes today, man. Or just write it down on a piece of paper. Where God guides, he provides. Come on, somebody. Where God guides, he provides. See, listen, take time to list your personal financial needs. That's right. Take time to identify them. Write them down on a piece of paper. Write them down as things that you want God to fulfill. Listen, that's why I have you bring a list every morning of your prayer requests, right? Not just your financial needs, but the needs that you may have for other areas in your life. And of course, bringing the needs of others as well to intercede for them. But list your personal financial needs. Make a list of them. See, these may include money for your home, your children's education, or for whatever it is, amen? Now hold this list before the Lord and say, God, this is what I need you to do for me in my life. Listen, where God guides, he provides. See, wrap your faith around it and watch Jehovah Jireh, our provider, begin to move in your life. But take the time to write the things down that you need from God. Write them down and watch God begin to move as your faith, amen, is released in these areas. God will begin to do great and mighty things. Remember, your faith responds when you focus on specific needs. See, your faith responds when you focus on specific needs. So target those areas in your life, release your faith in them, believe that God can do it, and God will 100% do something great and mighty in those areas. But write them down, put them on paper, and focus. And you know, sometimes we have a difficult time writing things down. You know, and sometimes, listen, not only just our needs, but our dreams. Listen, put this in the chat right now. Dare to dream. That's right, dare to dream. Put that in the chat. Look what Psalms 105:19 says. Until the time came to fulfill his dream, to fulfill his dreams, the Lord tested Joseph's character. I gotta read that one more time. This is so powerful. In Psalms 105:19, write this down. Until the time came to fulfill his dreams, the Lord tested Joseph's character. My goodness, this is so, listen, you need to understand this principle of what we're reading here today. When you dream, while you're waiting for God's dream to manifest, God will be testing your character to make sure, here we go, to make sure that when he puts you in that place that you're dreaming of, that you'll be able to maintain and sustain where you are. See, your dream is the seed for your future reality. Oh man, write that down, put that in the chat. Your dream is the seed for your future reality. Oh my goodness, listen, I'll tell you what, when you dream, you have to write it down. Here we go again. I'm telling you, I just said it a few minutes ago. I gotta repeat this. Not just write your needs down, but write your dreams down. Oh man, write, have you written them down? Do you have them on paper? Put them somewhere where you could see them. Create a vision board, amen. Listen, we've done this in the past. Rosa and I have done this. We've cut out pictures of the things that we desire and we put them on a refrigerator and we put them there and we say, you know, Lord, one day I want to live in a home that's like this and one day I want to have this vehicle that I want to drive. And listen, it's not that we're materialistic. It's just that we need goals, amen. Things that will inspire you and motivate you to continue to go forward. So we took pictures of all these things. Do you know that at the time when we put the pictures on the refrigerator, we had no vehicle. In other words, we had no way of getting to those dreams. We had no financial path to be on that would actually get us to be financially in those areas. But do you know that God, as we continue to pray, began to open doors in different areas of my life? And of course, I started a mortgage company. And Lord, just, I mean, it was so amazing how God manifested. And not only did we get the pictures that we took from the magazine, not only did we get those things, we got better things than that. And God just showed us that when you have a vision and you have a dream and you write it down or you put it in front of you, then you have something you can pray about and God will begin to move you. You'll begin to attract those things to you as you seek the Lord and you keep everything in order. Have you documented your goals, you know, in detail on paper? That's right. Document your goals and work them backwards. I always say, put down your goals and then put down your daily path, your daily goals to get to your primary goal. That's right. Well, seeing a picture, do it, man. Put it in front of you. It's going to be, now this may seem petty, right, to write stuff down, but how would you know where to go without a plan? What are the areas that you're going to improve on in your life that you're going to make an effort? See, when you make the effort, God does the work. So you have to make sure, though, that you have a plan, that you have something in place. If your plan is to get closer to God, then what are you going to do to get closer to God? You're going to read the Bible every day, amen. You're going to join me on this program every day. You're going to get closer to God, right? You're going to start doing certain things and setting certain a plan, right? You're going to make sure you go to church whenever the doors are open and worship the Lord together with your family. You're going to start doing all these things because your goal is to get closer to God. So now you're going to get into a small group, right, and connect with others as well. So you put a list of the things that you're going to do that's going to get you closer to the Lord. Listen, that is a plan. Then all you do is execute the plan and watch how God will begin to draw you closer to Him as you do, as He draws, and He'll draw closer to you as you draw closer to Him. Listen, put this in the chat, write this down. A plan is a written map to your future. A plan is a written map to your future. Listen, oh my goodness, losers focus on what they are going through. Champions focus on what they are going to. Oh, come on now. Somebody's gotta write that, put that in the chat right now. That was a drop mic moment. Losers focus on what they're going through. Champions focus on what they're going to. My goodness. Listen, focus on what God has for you. Listen, you're going to go through some stuff. It's going to be challenging. You only see what you're going through when you're looking to the left and to the right. But when you're going to something, you're focusing on that. You're focusing on your destination. You're focusing on what God has placed in your heart. And you're not looking to the other areas, to the left or to the right. Listen, Peter was able to walk on water. When Jesus called him out, he obeyed God's word. He stepped out of the boat. He began to walk on the water. But you see, he only began to sink when he took his eyes off the Lord. He began to see the waves and the wind and the storm and the lightning. When he took his eyes off the Lord and focused in on the things around him, it distracted him, distracted his faith, amen, and he began to sink. Listen, don't worry about what you're going through. Keep your eyes on what you're going to, amen? Write it down, that way you can stay focused. And I believe that when you put all these things on paper, listen, we're talking about putting all the things that God desires in your heart. Listen, keeping God first, right? Making sure that he's a priority. You know, identify your needs and then identify your dreams. Put them on paper, write a plan. It may seem outlandish, it may seem difficult, but God specializes in the impossible. Put that in the chat right now. God specializes in the impossible. And I believe that all these things that we're talking about, all the things that I've mentioned just now, you know, it's all about building self-confidence. Oh, here we go. Building self-confidence. You know, building confidence. You put that in the map. Put it on the chat right now. Build self-confidence. See, as you keep writing these things down, as you write down your needs and your dreams, you keep God first of all, then you start building this confidence on the inside that God can do it, that you are able to walk into what God has for you. Look what Psalm 71 verse 5, excuse me, Psalm 71 verse 5 says this: "For you are my hope, O Lord. God, you are my confidence from my youth." Oh my goodness, I gotta repeat that one more time. "For you are my hope, O Lord God. You are my confidence from my youth." See, when I read this, I realize that David, as a shepherd boy, had a lot of confidence in God, had a lot of confidence in himself, because before he ever faced a giant, he took down a bear, he took down a lion. Come on, somebody. At the end of the day, you need to have confidence in the gifts that God has put in your heart. Listen, I'm not talking about being arrogant or prideful. I'm just saying being confident, knowing what you have inside of you, putting your goals and dreams in writing, and keeping God first will build that confidence that you need on the inside. Listen, write this if you're taking notes. Man, we're having an awesome time this morning. If you believe for the best, then you can achieve the best. Oh, come on now. If you can believe for the best, then you can achieve the best. See, remember that God sent his son that you may enjoy an abundant life. See, that the good things that you want for yourself, there's nothing wrong. There's nothing selfish with wanting a good life for yourself and your family. But you have to remember that this is very important. Listen, God's gifts are not guaranteed. You have to receive them. Oh, come on, somebody. That's right. You have to receive what God is giving you, not just being offered. Just because God's being offering something doesn't mean that you're grabbing a hold of it. See, receive what God has given you. Receive all the gifts and talents that he's placed in your life. Listen, God gave Israel the promised land, but they had to claim it. Come on, somebody. They had to claim the land. They had to go out and physically go out and take it. Listen, God wants you to understand that everything he has in you has equipped you for what he's doing for you and in you. That's right. Absolutely. God has placed everything inside of you. So listen, go forth, man. Don't hold back. Don't shrink back on what God is doing. In Jesus' name, listen, convince yourself. This is important. Convince yourself that beyond a shadow of a doubt that you have the ability to earn the rewards you desire. Oh, come on now. Convince yourself. Listen, speak to yourself, man. Sometimes you got to look in the mirror and say, man, come on. You are good. You are strong. You're anointed. Man, look in the mirror and speak to yourself. Speak good things over yourself, over your heart, and over your mind as well. Listen, declare God's promises in your circumstances. Declare God's promises because you are a masterpiece. Come on, somebody. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. So don't focus on what you're going through. Focus on what you're going to and claim God's promise. Be convinced. You must be sold on yourself. Come on, somebody. I'm just going to keep it real and practical today. You got to be sold on yourself. You got to be sold on your skills, sold on your opportunities, sold on your potential, on your attitude, sold on your character, sold on your calling. That's right. You need to believe in yourself. Listen, if you believe in yourself, if you're sold on yourself, then others will buy into you as well. Oh, come on, put that in the chat right now. We're keeping it real this morning. If you're sold on yourself, then others will buy into you. And that is such an important part of going out and accomplishing what God has for you in your life. Listen, if you desire it, if you have that thing in your heart that wants to accomplish, listen, step out and do it. God wants you to step out today in faith, convincing yourself, build up that self-confidence, speak good things over yourself. And I believe God is going to manifest all kind of amazing things in your life. Amen. Remember, when you're sold on yourself, then other people will buy into you. Because before people buy into what you have, they have to buy into you first. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Wow. Listen, if you're coming in late right now, you got to hit replay after this thing is done. You got to hit replay. You got to watch this from the beginning. I believe God had an encouraging word for so many of us today, especially in the season that we're in, where we've been kind of isolated for a while, where we've kind of been closed in. Listen, it's time to break out of our shell. It's time to take off all the stuff that's been holding us down. Listen, stop listening to all the negativity. Stop. You know, I spoke with somebody yesterday that, you know, we've been having church in our building for a long time. It's been months and months already, right? We never stopped having church. We had church in the parking lot when we couldn't have church on the inside. It's because we believe that gathering together is God's purpose, right? There are still people who are not back in church yet. I'm thinking, my gosh, you need to do that. You need to get back into life, man. Don't allow these things to hold you back, because remember, God has special plans and purposes, and he uses the body of Christ. So listen, step out, be confident in what you have. It's time to rise up and believe God for healing, believe God for protection over our lives, that when we step out, listen, and go into these places, and we go to church, listen, God has us covered, amen, by his blood and through the blood of Jesus this morning. Praise God. Oh my goodness. I'll tell you what, make sure you hit play, watch this again, share this. Please get this out to folks. They need to hear an encouraging word today. And I believe God spoke to us very clearly today about what he wants in our lives. Amen. Praise God. Well, listen, we're going to take a little time to pray right now. If you're tuning in, just lift up your hands right now. Just begin to praise the Lord. Just begin to give him glory and honor this morning. Just close your eyes and lock yourself in with God right now. Father, in Jesus' name, we just thank you this morning. You're such a good God and such an amazing God. And we love you this morning. And we thank you for all that you do for us, for your goodness, for your grace and your mercy upon our lives. And in Jesus' name, Father, we make you a priority in our lives. Father God, we place you first in our lives. We place you first in our day, Lord God, which shows you how important you are, that we would wake up early just to spend time in your presence. We put you first in our finances when we bring our tithes and our offerings before you and say that you're greater than those things, oh God. And we thank you for what you do and keeping the windows of heaven opened over us, oh God, in Jesus' name. And Father God, help us to identify our needs, oh God. To identify our our needs and put them on paper, write things down, Lord God. Not just keep them in our mind, but grab a piece of paper and put down the needs, the wants, the things that you want to desire for yourself and for your family, Father. Help us to make notes of those things, Father God, and put them on paper so we can be specific. Even the people we want to intercede for, Lord God, help us to write it down so we can have a plan for our prayer. Hallelujah, because prayer has a plan. So in Jesus' name, oh God, I thank you, Lord God, for all the needs being met. And Father God, we'll write down the dreams that we have, oh God. We know that in Jesus' name, before you gave Joseph his dream, Lord God, you tested his character. And many of us are in that place right now, oh God, where we're being tested in the name of Jesus. We're going through challenges right now because you're testing us before we get our dream. So hallelujah, we thank you, Lord God, that we're moving in the right direction, that if we're in a test right now, we know we're moving towards what you have for us, and what you have for us is moving towards us as well. So Father, we thank you, we praise you in Jesus' name. And Father God, help us to build the confidence in you, to build that confidence that you have planted every good thing inside of us, that you have equipped us, oh God, to do what you've called us to do on this earth, that you've equipped us to fulfill our assignment, oh God, and on this planet, oh God, in Jesus' name. So Father God, we know that we have all the skills, we have all the aptitude and the right attitude to accomplish everything we need. So Father, we will go forth not shrinking back, not thinking less of ourselves, but knowing that what we bring to the table every day is what others need, oh God. So in Jesus' name, we thank you. Let that confidence build up inside of us, oh God, so we can accomplish the things that you have for us. So Father, we thank you, Lord God, that even now we can speak and we can declare it, that I am a child of God. I am equipped to do what God has called me to do. I am God's conduit of blessing. Your blessings flow through me onto others, oh God. My words have power, and what I say makes an impact. My heart and my attitude is contagious towards God. And Father, I thank you that we can draw people to the Lord, that we can draw people to you, my God, with our attitude and the confidence that we bring, that you always are there, that you'll never leave us, never forsake us, that you will accomplish all that you have for us in Jesus' name. And right now, oh God, we lay hands on the prayer requests. We pray for the people, we intercede for our friends and our families and our colleagues and those around us, Lord God. We pray for salvation, that today will be their day of salvation. Draw them closer to you. Bring them to the cross right now in Jesus' name. We pray for healing. Let your miraculous healing power be loosed upon your people. We know it's by your stripes that we were healed. We just declare healing over all of those that are on our list, including Pastor Carmen and Mama Rosa and my brothers and my brother Dave, who's recovering from surgery, and everyone else. Oh God, just touch them right now in Jesus' name and heal them. Hallelujah. We pray for deliverance, for chains to be broken over people's lives, for habits, hallelujah, to be torn down, strongholds to be torn down as well, oh God. They're not just habits, they're strongholds. So in Jesus' name, we come against a strong man that would try to bind them up. In Jesus' name, we declare their freedom. We speak it over them right now. And we thank you that they are free from those habits, free from the hurts, no longer holding on to the pain of the past, but looking forward, Lord God, to the prosperity, to the path of prosperity that you have us on, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you right now, Father. And Lord, we pray for your provision. We pray you'll continue to provide. Give us this day our daily bread. So continue to provide every day what we need and what those need on our list as well. Provide for every need. Restore and heal relationships and marriages, oh God, in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father God, and we just receive it in the name of Jesus. And Father, we just thank you for the victory this morning. We thank you, Father God, that the blood of Jesus cleanses us of all unrighteousness. We thank you that we are forgiven this day for all of our shortcomings as we confess them to you right now. And we thank you, Father God, for your forgiveness. Help us to walk, Lord God. Help us to turn away from sin, turn away from bad habits and wickedness, turn away from all the flesh, oh God, and walk in your presence, in your victory, in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. Give the Lord a praise this morning. Oh my goodness. I tell you, I feel the release of the Holy Spirit this morning. Listen, I'm going to boost this particular program on Facebook Live or Facebook. If you get a chance, do it. Put it on Instagram as well. Amen. That others can hear what we spoke about today. And I believe the prayer of the righteous availeth much. Amen. So consider it done right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Well, you know, I always close with a scripture. And today's scripture is found in Psalms 55, verse 17, verse 55. I'm sorry, chapter 55, verse 17 of the Psalms. It says this, evening and morning and at noon I will pray. Oh, hallelujah, and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. Evening and morning and at noon I will pray. That's right, man. That's pretty. That, listen, that's a formula for victory. You know, waking up in the morning and praying on our program. At lunchtime, take a few minutes to pray. Pray over, not just pray over your food, but pray over certain needs that you may have. You know, compartmentalize how you pray. Maybe you want to intercede for people at lunch. You want to pray, in the morning. And maybe you want to pray for your needs, all right, at lunchtime. And then in the evening, just pray for God's greatness and goodness to just protect you and guard you as you sleep. I believe that is a formula for success. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, listen. I want to pray God's blessing over you. But, you know, I want to charge you to do something today. Show kindness to someone today. Put that down in the chat. Show kindness to someone today. That's right. Be kind. You know, be a blessing to someone. And remember, tonight is Double Dose. Come on. This is Double Dose Tuesday. Tonight at 7 p.m., Pastor Martin and the New Life Intercessory team will be gathering together. So make sure you tune into that. That's tonight on the conference call at 7 p.m. with the New Life Prayer team led by Pastor Martin as well. So listen, God bless you. Father God, I pray your blessing over your people. Bless them and keep them. Shine your face upon them and be gracious to them. Lift up your countenance towards them and give them peace. Let your peace cover them right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Listen, God bless you. And listen, have a blessed day. And remember that when you're walking in the spirit, you will not fulfill the desires of the flesh. Have a blessed day. God bless you. And Lord willing, I'll see you again tomorrow morning right here at 7 a.m. on the Walking in the Spirit program. God bless you.